When I first started to carve in high school, several of the boys came up to me in the class and said, girls aren't allowed to carve. It made me really nervous, and I backed off carving for all that time that I didn't think girls weren't allowed to do certain kinds of artwork from our culture. I've spent my whole life learning it anyway and doing it anyway. Gaila kesla, nukwa am ikkawaka. My English name is Luann Neal, and I'm from the Mamalilakla and the Kwagil people of the Kwakwakiwak. Started off painting and drawing, and then onto textiles, jewelry. I've been experimenting with digital design and other kinds of carvings.
It fascinates me how they make use of all of the layers of the rings of the tree to bring out that face.
My grandmother's been, I think, one of the biggest influences on my whole artistic practice.
Ellen Neal was her grandmother. She was a groundbreaker for a lot of First Nation women artists.
That's my grandmother's. She was way ahead of her time. When I saw what she was able to do in her era, I thought I wanted to learn more about where she left off so I could pick it up and carry it the rest of the way.
I don't think Luann will ever stop evolving. She can be very traditional when she wants to be, and very contemporary when she does her digital art. And her art is just exceptional.
Using technology was always of real interest to me, so I enrolled in Emily Carr University and had a chance to really learn about how your artistic practice can come true in any way you want to, and that technology is just another tool. Learning it by touch and how much space. It's very hard to describe the feeling you get when you get to put your hands on the same piece that your grandmother, your dad, or your great-grandfather, or any relative has had their hands on there for so long, creating that piece. Just imagining having a knife and carving. Oh, it even smells. It's your own individual moment to spend time with that wood and to connect with that wood. Wow. It's good energy. And I start seeing designs in my mind's eye. Being a recipient of the Fulmer Award is probably, the biggest surprise of my life. I cried when they called me because I couldn't believe. It's strange because when I go about my art, I just go about my art. I think a lot of artists I've spoken to, they don't think that what they do is anything special. They just do what they were taught. It's most important that you believe in yourself. Don't let anyone tell you you can't. Make that the reason why you do. I put my work out there as a symbol and a signifier of who I am and who our people are. That's when I feel like I'm an artist.